I'm Ian Bowen.
Hi. I also am Ian Bowen.
You know, we are technically challenged, but we're back.
We're back. It's been a long, long ass time.
We did it at Michael's house, remember? In between something or other. I drove up there.
Oh.
That was our last one. That was in May?
May? No, April. I think it was around my birthday.
April?
It was when I came home from my birthday.
So we're finally back home, both together in the same...
August. 4 months. We haven't seen each other in 4 months.
I know. It's my birthday next month.
In September.
It is. I know it is. September
11th. September 11th.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching. We love you. We miss you. We're so excited. We've been talking about this.
September 11th.
That's fucking Tyler's birthday. No.
Yours is September 30th.
The only thing that's 30 is Tyler Hoechlin's going to be 30 this year. He's going to be an old bastard.
He is. I told him that I'm going to go to his party.
30 years old.
We have to go and celebrate that with him. Yours is the 23rd. 24th. Yours is 19th. Yours is the 17th.
Whose teeth are whiter?
It's on. Your birthday's in my phone, so and that's my phone. So I'm on my 24th.
Hello from Germany.
Hello, Germany.
So, guys, just a quick catch up because we're not as funny as we think we are. tell me what you've been doing for the last 4 months. Wait, I messed up. Since I've seen you last. Actually, tell me about. The most recent, let's go backwards. What'd you have for breakfast?
I'm drinking my bulletproof tea.
I
finished that movie. Are we too far back? Should we move forward? There's a lot of headroom above us. Is that right?
Better?
I like it
bright. Okay.
I just finished a movie with Emmanuel Shrieky, you know, one of my best friends, mm-hmm. and Sam Schimmel, who is amazing, and Jim Beaver, who's brilliant.
What's the movie called?
And Connor McVicker. The movie's called Hospitality. Howard Barish, you know who, 13th, that brilliant documentary by
Ava DuVernay.
Yes.
Yeah.
He produced that and a bunch of other movies. Just an incredible man.
Right. I remember getting the script and I was like, guys, I'm not right for this. But I really appreciate it, but I think.
Oh, is that when you said you should get JR to do this?
No, they were like, he's somewhere on the list, but we have to look. I came back around, I'm so happy. I'm just kidding. I don't get to work anymore.
That's not true.
Hospitality,
great movie. Emmanuel is wonderful, and everybody's wonderful in it.
Can I tell everybody how you said it reinvigorated your fire in your life for
really
work?
Did. Yeah, it really did.
I find that interesting.
Yeah.
A lot of times we have to do work like everyone else does for a job to make money or to do whatever. And it's not fun. Sometimes you hate going to work in the morning. And sometimes you get a job that feels like you're just plugging into the current of life and whatever. And you feel necessary. So when your friends tell you about those jobs that they're doing, it really makes you hopeful.
It was amazing. It was a lot of fun. It was really great.
That's cool.
Yeah. So now I'm going to throw my hat into trying to get, the movie that I optioned, Skipping Stones, mm-hmm. do a little bit of work on that. And I think I might put a play up at the end of October with Laura Trillo. Will you come and see it? Just a small little one act. She's amazing. She's from New York, amazingly talented actor. And she's now living here and one of my oldest friends. And so we might just kind of do something low key.
Cool.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You are working on a tummy. You've been freaking busy.
I've been a little bit busy. I'm growing my hair out.
Like everywhere.
Yes, I have a beard. You may or may not have noticed. Wouldn't it be funny if just the whole thing came off? That would have been dope. Because I'm playing a cowboy in a new TV show called Yellowstone. It's about a family and the family turmoil and the politics of the development in land and native peoples and infighting. And it's a contemporary sort of modern day Western set in Montana, shooting in Utah and Montana. So that's fun. So I'm doing that. I'm getting to ride around, play horses, and cows and Indians. And 2 days ago, I was on a horse and I was herding
sheep.
Buffalo.
Buffalo.
You know how big buffalo are? They are 2 times the size of a horse. They weigh like 3,000 pounds. And they're 7 feet tall, like the hump. Anyway, so it's really exciting. A lot of great people I'm meeting. I'm getting to work with some fantastically gifted actors and some really well-known movie stars, so that's fun.
And you're enjoying yourself.
Yeah.
You look great. I mean, you look at all this.
That's why I blow myself out with the light, so you can't really see.
I can see in the other
still look yeah, great. I feel good. I'm very happy.
I'll bet you are. You talk like with a, you know.
No, I try to make sure I don't do that specifically.
Why?
Because it's a stereotype that's lazy as an actor. If you think sometimes you're like, oh, cowboy, you know, just talks like this a little bit, and you know, he has beer, and you know, goes to work, he does things like that. The important thing, he lives a good life, but that's not necessarily him, because it's in your mind like a hook, because that's just easy. So I have to actually not do that when you might want to. It's interesting. It's a different kind of work that I've done in a while.
Nice.
And it's challenging.
Nice.
So that's fun.
And before that, you were doing a bunch of traveling.
The Teen Wolf conventions that you guys like to go to, that we like to come say hi to you at over the summer. Did some of those, which I missed you at. You were meant to come to a few.
Born in Amsterdam.
Not as much fun without you. Oh, and then my favorite thing of the summer was the Life Ride. Good God. And so he just started this movie. If you guys don't know, Life Ride. Keel's Life Ride. This is the 8th
for Amphar.
For Amphar, benefiting AIDS.
Which we did
HIV
together last year.
Yeah, it's a band of brothers on bikes, raising awareness and raising money, making noise for AIDS and HIV. And Amphar is the company that takes money and actually makes research, and they do things, and they put the things and the stuff, and
they
come
truly,
up with cures.
Yeah, and
they're doctors.
They're Amphar's Kevin Frost. They have an amazing. They're sort of, I mean, they will find a cure for it.
They think by 2020,
but the thing that they do is that they will find, you know, a doctor wherever in the world that is gaining the greatest advancements or doing the sort of most beneficial research, and they give their funding instead of spreading
yes.
it out.
Yes, so that year it was Dr. Daniela Farah.
Yeah.
And she's a grant recipient, and so over our lifetime, over 8 days, we raised over $150,000, and that goes direct to her and her work. And she's on the younger side. Most the research scientists that have done the most work in the past are well over 40, but Kevin Frost was telling me about a study that found that the Nobel Prize winners, if you look back through history, had done the bulk of their work in advancement from between like 20 and 30.
Oh,
so,
wow.
So Amphar's looking for new people with new ideas, younger people, and this grant recipient, Dr. Farah, who's just wonderful, is going to be doing that work, and they're finding it. So we go on the Life Ride. I know we got caught up in the details to help that. So I did that, and our buddy Posey came with us this year.
Tyler Posey.
Tyler
he plays
Posey.
Teen Wolf on a show called Teen Wolf.
I bit him in the hand.
Oh, yeah.
Remember when he was... That was me. Those eyes in the woods.
Yeah.
Get credit for episode one. So Jero couldn't make it. He had to do this incredible film on conflicting schedules. But the Life Ride was great. You can see pictures all over the internet.
Yeah.
We're going to do it again next year. We're going to keep riding until Kevin Frost is out of a job.
Here, here.
So that was great.
I hope we're all there together next year.
Which reminds me, they sent me a picture.
Oh, here's a picture. Why did they send... So there isn't one of us when the year that we went.
Not like this. So this came in the mail. It is. It's our group of riders, and I'm just gonna push it. I mean, I don't want to lose you.
Can you move it to the left?
Yep, there it is. So anyway, there's me and Grant, Luke, Chris, Giles, and Posey. So that was this year's Life Ride 8, and they sent us this nice thing. It's got like a thing you can frame, you can put it on, you know, like the desk or something.
Oh, because you've not seen that before.
Yeah, well, I don't have any. Why? I just realized I don't have any photos around my house. So this morning I looked trying to.
Wait, are you serious? Like that? You know, like every frame pretty much has that. You know, the new thing for you to see that? It's like,
yes, I don't have any
that's
pictures.
That's a special frame. Look, they sent me this, and it has this thing that I can put it on a desk. They all have that. Not all, but a lot. That's not
how some of them just hang on the wall.
Yeah, the majority of them do that. They so they can sit on a desk. Come on, seriously? Don't.
So then I was thinking, my house isn't very homey because I don't have any pictures. And then I thought, that's because I'm a robot.
Are you a robot? Is that why I sometimes feel that your love for me is very mechanical?
Yes, but our relationship moves forward like a well-oiled machine.
Not as well-oiled that I just...
Be right back.
Lord. So that's been great. And I think, you know, listen, we're not gonna delve too deep into this, I don't think, but I do think that it's important to at least mention. Things have been going great. We're very, very happy. But in you know, unfortunately, and at the same time, it feels like the state of things are just getting more and more fucked up. And so that is, I think, you know, we're coexisting with that as
sure.
well. And I think it's important to have an awareness of that. And I think it's important to, you know, I think when we, you know, when we do... repost or retweet or bring attention, I think it is important, and I hope that you all do take the time and look into it. You know, Kendrick Sampson, who's brilliant and such an amazing advocate, you know, I think it's important, even while we're doing everything else, that we do still take the time to educate and to realize and to acknowledge and then to use our voice in whatever way that is, everyone out there, for
yeah, I think so.
Out against and you know.
Don't give up.
Yeah.
Be aware of what's going on.
Yeah.
Read, take a look at the situation, and don't let things that are not okay continue.
Exactly.
Just,
and that shit,
just,
you know,
no.
Ben Cohen talked about that too. Our buddy who did the ride with us last year.
Benny.
He,
Benji.
You know, you don't have to. It's not like there has to be this amazing sort of you know,
movement right
presence. If you're at school, if you're at a grocery store, if you're at a shopping mall, and you see racism happening around you, you see bullying happening around you, you see any type of unfair profile, whatever that is, I think that there are safe ways, and there are definitely ways that you can interject, and you can get involved, and you can speak the truth, and you can stand up for.
Just don't give up.
Yeah.
You don't have to necessarily be the hero of the day. But if you start to go, nah, it's okay, then everyone's going to start to be okay. And then it'll be okay.
Yeah.
So just don't forget who you are.
Yeah. And I think that, you know, regardless of everything else, I think that's sort of to not to say that, right?
Yes.
Because that definitely weighs, and I think you agree, I know it does with you as well, it still weighs fucking
yeah,
heavy.
Yeah, it's a daily thing.
Yeah.
I will say one interesting, fun aspect of traveling and working out of town is that, and being especially remote when you have no signal, is not reading the news and watching the whole show and just being kind of back to normal and
right.
being unplugged a bit. And I found myself quite a bit emotionally much more happy than usual because I wasn't ruminating in all of the nonsense going on in the world. I just sort of got up and did my thing and went to work. So you can have those moments of unpluggedness and still be happy. I guess the point of why we started talking about this is because we're both very happy and things are going well.
Yes.
And we don't want to lose
but at
sight.
This, yes, know. But at the same time, I don't want to paint this picture because as amazing and as happy there is still this weight, you know, I think the man that is fucking running this country right now, Donald Trump, is just an unfortunate.
He's a lunatic.
Yeah, and he's an unfortunate, dysfunctional, troubled man. And he's not unique in that sense. There are a ton of dysfunctional, troubled human beings out there. It's just unfortunate that this man has the platform that he does. There's a part of me that just wishes Twitter and our media would just go, and fucking nothing, you know what I mean? Take that away.
Take the voice away.
Yeah, but so, you know, I think that it's, you know what I mean? It's,
yeah.
We have work to do, and I think it's easier than it might appear at times, you know what I mean?
I sure do.
Yeah.
Let's get some comments here. Donald is Jesus.
what did that say?
They're just commenting on politics. A lot of people from France. A lot of people from Spain watching.
Werewolves and Hunters, yep.
Mm-hmm.
But
we
love
you guys too. Hi to everybody. We're happy that you guys hit the little heart button and comment. We're happy we see them all. We can't necessarily say hi to everybody, although I was
there. Hello, Germany. That was really, that's a lot. Amazing actors. It's pretty terrible. Oh, yes, it is. It is. Would you like to see more scenes? Yes, we wish we could do more scenes together. How fucking great would Posey and Lyndon do with their episodes? Posey directed the episode before, and it was one of my favorite ones to work on. And then Lyndon, the follow-up, again, one of, so great working.
Mm-hmm. That was just last Sunday.
Lyndon's was last, the first of the two.
Yeah.
Tim did the second one, I think.
Yeah, but Lyndon's was just a week. Was a week yesterday.
Yes, but
tomorrow.
But we had two episodes back to back last Sunday.
But first not 2 weeks ago is what I'm saying.
No. Yeah, last Sunday. Yes, last Sunday.
Last Sunday.
Two episodes.
I Lyndon know that, the first but not one. 2 weeks ago. I was. Posey there hasn't been one since then.
Posey did.
Since Lyndon's.
Posey did 2 weeks ago.
I feel like we're saying the same thing.
I know we're saying the same thing.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's really nice
right?
to see.
They did great
everybody's
jobs.
Direct episodes. And so we've got four to go.
Is that it?
Oh, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Guys, it's getting close to being the very, very final.
Oh,
speaking of Teen Wolf, and this is in that, the not that it's even related, but the VMAs are tomorrow.
Yeah.
And they are on MTV. I'm actually going to go, so I'll see you guys there. I'll try to do some cool stuff and say hello, and I'll be with the boys and the girls and whatnot.
We were going as...
We were
going
to be
dates,
but
I'm afraid that I have some
more important things to do.
It's not that it's more important at
well,
all.
It is.
It isn't. You know that how much fun we would have had, but I do have some work regarding
work.
Hospitality.
I don't have any work.
Regarding the movie.
Not in the movie. No one asked me to be in the movie.
What about our movie? Where's that at?
God damn it! It's coming.
Just write the damn thing, would ya?
Okay. Speaking of movies, go see Wind River. It's in theaters now. Jeremy Renner, Elizabeth Olsen, and Ian. Really, it's flawlessly executed.
I'm no doubt.
It's enjoyable as F. I'm trying to cuss less. So I just do like a breathing. I don't know. I so enjoy the purchase of foul language.
I think that there's words that we,
has a nice bite to it.
Everyone, adult Texas, take care.
Oh, geez, that's right.
Mandatory
Texas on the TV. So apparently, there's going to be 3 feet of rain in the next couple of days in Texas. So, I'm all for prayers, but actions are very important.
Everything.
If you're nearby and you can help, do. If you can donate, do.
Yeah. Oh, that's
right. Open your
Red Cross.
Yeah, if you can open your doors and take in people that need things, and then the rebuilding aspect obviously will take a lot of effort.
Please.
So, if you've got some more gloves and your gloves, go help.
I'm going to a cystic fibrosis event today. A charity event.
That's fantastic.
That Rosie G is putting on.
Where is it at?
At the Houdini Estate.
Where's the Houdini Estate?
It's up in the Hollywood Hills.
I don't know. It's hard to find.
She's a... Did I totally set that up for you? That was really good.
You did.
I did not see
that. I was
that
like,
color.
You don't even see it coming, but I do. You know, yours was better. If I said, where's that? You'd have been, I don't know. No one can find it.
I don't know. No one can find it. The Houdini Estate. She's a young fashion designer. She, Grace Rose, and her design, her line of clothing is called Rosie G. And she has cystic fibrosis as well. Her and my niece have become quite good friends via social media, which is great. I'm going to go to that. For a couple hours today, watch the fashion show.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I'm excited.
I've got plans this afternoon with some friends that I haven't seen in, this year, and it's already August. I'm going to watch this boxing fight match.
Oh, I heard tonight. There's a boxing.
There's a wrestling event game.
Wrestling tennis match.
There's a participation trophy.
Who are you?
There. I read the papers, and the papers all say that the boxer is going to win the boxing fight, and that the other guy is going to get his ass kicked. But
why are you not using their names?
Because I didn't want to get them wrong. I have a weird thing.
You have a lot of weird
speaking
things.
Of names, like, if we're talking, you know how, okay, back up. You know sometimes goats, like, if there's fainting goats, and if you surprise them, they just go, and then they fall over. I have a similar thing, like, if we'll be talking, and someone comes up that I don't know very well, and they'll just be like, hey, Ian, and I'll be like, instantly their name goes, and then I can't say anything for fear of forgetting it, but I know it.
Getting it wrong.
Right.
Yeah.
And so I freeze.
Yeah. I don't freeze. You know what I do? I just throw out names that I think it might be.
And so sometimes I would freeze, and then he could see it. Not that I spit on you. And then he could be like, hey, who's your friend?
Yes.
And then
I'm good at that.
Yeah.
I really am.
And that, so that's the saving.
Even if there isn't an introduction right away, I'm right, you know, if I notice that my friend isn't right away saying this is, then I say like, hey.
Mayweather.
I'm JR.
I think Mayweather's going to beat McGregor, which is your sister's new surname.
How do you remember that?
Oh my God. It's all up here.
Just now another reason.
Yes, right.
McGregor. That's my sister's name. She married Jeff McGregor. Madison McGregor. Ava.
My mother is texting me.
Is she watching it?
Yeah, she is.
Did she say that she likes me better than you?
No, she's mad about the buffalo.
Why?
Because I was herding buffalo and it's very dangerous. So buffalo can run faster than horses and they can knock a horse over and then kill it and then kill the rider.
Shut up, sir.
Oh, yeah. Like, and just beep. They're like cars. So you're not really supposed to get close to them. We didn't. It just looks like we're getting close to them.
Please say something about the Eclipse convention in Germany. It got canceled.
It did?
In Dusseldorf? In December?
I'm not going.
Yeah, as far as I know, it got canceled.
So we don't know about that.
No, I was told that it was canceled. The lunar eclipse in Dusseldorf in December.
Don't know about it.
Yeah,
you guys still like going to conventions? You guys still think there's something?
Man, you have really blue eyes. So do you. I'm trying to read. Oh my God. He, Peter, a beard. Oh yeah, Peter's got a beard. Yeah, look at you.
Mine are still a lot bigger though than yours.
Yeah, I have this beard. I can't wait thing. It's, I don't know, I'm trying it out and see how it works.
Listen to your mother, Ian. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Can you all come back to the UK soon? I would love to.
We're thinking that there's going to be a new convention thing in London.
Oh,
that hasn't been for a couple of years. Yeah.
I don't get invited anymore. What happened? Did I piss somebody off?
No.
What?
Oh.
Hopefully we'll get it.
So if you guys are in the UK, you missed that.
Any of you going to come to... I would love that. Can we please make that happen?
Yeah.
Ireland. Never been. Would love to go to Ireland.
That's great.
Let them know you appreciate it. We do. I love you both. We love you too.
When do you think we should try to hook up for another one of these?
Molly Ball, when we all come to the UK next? I think we just ended
that. Yeah, we're working on that.
Lord the Seventh is watching some... It's too fast. I love them so... And Mava, love you guys. I love your eyes. Thank you. We love you.
So just the guys, the comments come in like two, and then they go. So it's really hard to...
Amy, there's a convention in
Cardiff
next month. I didn't know that. Oh, I'm going to Australia in March.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm going to do those two.
Supernova?
I think so, yeah.
What cities?
Brisbane and
those two cities?
The two 1 week in a time. I've never been. Never been.
It's outstanding.
Haven't even been for Stargate Day, so it's like...
Yeah, you'll have a really good time.
I'm excited. Later, got to go back to cleaning. Hey, do you want to pull it up and see if we can answer a couple of questions before we check out of here?
I'll try to do a few real quick. And then we'll see you hopefully in a couple of weeks' time. Oh, God, I hope it's on. Why can't
there it is, from the century. Go down. There it is.
Oh, we got it. Then.
Here we go.
You need to sing more.
Sing. You need to sing more.
Right? I don't know any songs.
Sing us a little song.
A song.
Let's do that song that we've been working on for
you're years. You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
No,
you're a stupid Mr. Grinch.
Do the one that we're writing together. Go ahead, you start.
Oh, it goes. That's a Max Carver special. I don't know how to do that.
One of my favorite skits from Saturday Night Live when what do you know?
They're just like, it's too much. I can't be focused on a computer. I need to be focused here. These are my intentions.
Fred Armisen and is it?
It's been a long time.
No,
sweet to talk.
Kristen, and they do the song.
Why aren't you backing me up right now?
Skit.
My love has been away for so long, but now it's back.
Sure. Come out of space. Give me this. We're gonna try to answer some
questions. This is usually the time when
we're gonna try to answer some questions.
There aren't really any questions.
Ian, I met you last September on your birthday. Do you remember?
I do. Roman. Roman. I'm an F from the Blueface. Sing Adele.
Come to Port. Sing Adele. Yeah, right.
You know, just the guitar this time, okay?
You know who could do it? Colton.
I love Adele.
So does Colton. Colton could sing Adele.
By the way,
do you see his post of his full moon? Do you see his full moon post?
Yeah, so he keeps taking vacations from what? I don't know.
And then he pulled his pants down in the ocean and exposed his entire bare ass.
I didn't see that.
It's on Instagram. And he said, they totally referenced the total eclipse. Fucking guy. Pedia shippers.
Pedia, yep, I'm a shipper of Pedia.
I love you both so much. Thanks, Rebecca. We love you guys too. How do you make this bigger?
I don't really know how to operate that. guys, I think we're close to signing off. Thank you for it. What's the word when you.
The most beautiful. Here we go. Here's
entertaining
a question.
Us.
Other than campaigns or shows, anything else new? I'm building a new motorcycle. Turning one of my Harleys into a bobber.
Don't know what that means.
My bike, hey, do a bobber. And then put a single seat, big fat tires, chop the fender on the back, change the handlebar, bigger tank, like a big fat tank. The pipes on the side. I'm very excited about
it. Pipes.
Where's your child, Charmin? He's in the UK.
I believe he's
Rome.
In Rome
shooting, a new series.
Shooting something about the Borgias or the. Some Italian epic family. We're very excited.
So this doesn't work, this computer?
I don't. Well, I just don't know how it does. Guys, we'll try to do this again.
Describe the team
next month.
Yes. See, I'm trying to get to questions here.
I feel like we're dragging.
He wants to wrap.
On and they're not like, getting
excited.
We've
been doing this for ages, so I feel bad. Why engaging any of that? Even if there's five people, who cares?
Oh, that's a good point.
Jeremy, listen, we're on a date. It's true. Yes,
you
exactly.
Can turn it off.
Hello from Portugal, both great actors. Jared, Melissa, hello. Questions, give us some questions before we wrap up here. Why doesn't this work?
What, it does.
How do you?
What are you trying to click?
I'm trying to make this bigger.
Make
so
it
that
bigger.
We can.
Like that?
No, that's too big.
It's not gonna give the box parameters any more room. It's just gonna show you a few. It's gonna go. Well, you can look through them. It doesn't normally.
But you know, normally we can pause. Like you can press the button and it will stop it from moving. You know what I mean? No more
double click on
here.
The video.
That's what I wanted.
There you go.
And then you can.
That's what we're looking at.
As JR ignores me, Bobo, you are my favorite.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Milagros. Why would you say I ignore you? No, I ignore you.
Ian, dude, I love you so. You know, guys, we hear a lot about inspiration of the Teen Wolf show and how it makes you guys feel good about yourselves and your work and whatever your interests are and your artistic ability and just your overall awesomeness. And if we can bring that out in any way by things that we do, we're blessed and we're happy to do it. And we do like to hear about it because it makes us feel like I think what we do is more important than just a TV show.
Yeah.
We're sort of improving some people's life quality, which
Megan wants to
make the best thing.
It very, very true, and that's what I love about all this shit.
That makes me feel so good every time we do this.
Megan wants to know, what's your favorite holiday? What's your favorite holiday?
I mean, Abraham Lincoln's birthday is right up there with... I don't know. Holidays are weird for me. I don't know. Christmas.
What's your favorite movie? Dante is asking.
Casablanca.
Edelsworth.
Right.
Ooh,
now.
Nice one.
Which I sing constantly.
And
Raiders of the Lost Ark. Those are my two favorite movies.
Woman Under the Influence. Cassavetes is one of my favorite ones. And
that was what's her name?
Jenna Rollins.
Yes.
Tell us when Peter is coming back.
He'll be back end of this season. Not a lot for Pete to do in 6B.
Right. It was great in the last episode.
Stopped. No, it wasn't.
We did. Yeah. That was the hell no. Ryan. Lydia Pedrosa Busca wants to know, what projects are you working on? We already told you that, dude. Scroll back to near the beginning and we talked about what we both have been up to.
Hospitality and Yellowstone.
Yep. Lisa wants to know, thoughts on the Jackson and Ethan storyline? Brown chicken, brown cow.
It's definitely an attention grabber, and I think it makes it up.
And it's great.
Yeah.
Amal wants to know, are you interested in visiting India? Yes.
Yes, I've been to India, and it's marvelous.
I would love
a few
to.
Months there.
What?
Yeah.
When?
Oh, geez.
Why have we never talked about this? Sunday mornings, where we're just lying in bed.
Wants to send you a message. Is that your, who's that?
I have no idea.
Yeah, India's spectacular.
For a few months, why?
I did a film there. In fact, a friend of mine is a film actor there, and he's constantly wanting to do stuff. And so I was thinking about going and tapping into the Bollywood market, because they're, you know, they see more movies than Americans do, people in India. So there's more eyes watching the screen, and they put out more content, and it's just more stuff.
Let's go do a movie in India. I would love that.
Could you imagine if we had like a revelatory, life changing, like 6 months in India, and just fucked everything else, and just went and wrung it out?
Can you call your friend and tell him that we both would love to come out and do a movie together
in
India?
In Bombay.
Where is Peter? Yasmin wants to know, where is Peter?
Peter.
It's right there.
Yeah. Oh, you mean the show? Oh, no idea. No idea.
He's off running through the forest, screwing some deer.
My mother wants to adopt you.
She does?
Yeah. She put the crying face emoticon, which means like you're laughing because you're so much that you cry. That's a nice way of saying it.
You know, mom was going, you can totally adopt.
My mom is going like this. And she's wiggling because she's so excited. Mom, take a video laughing at us with us in the background. So like, do this, right?
A selfie.
A selfie video and post it on Instagram. And then, send it to me of you doing that laugh, and I'll put it on Instagram and everyone can watch.
That's pretty cute.
That'd
love it,
cool.
Mom.
I dare you to do that.
Savasti wrote, just Greece.
Greece.
I would love to go to Greece.
Yeah, I haven't been to Greece.
Should we next year. Should we do maybe the Greek islands or something?
I think I want to go to Croatia next year to Split or the Bar.
Can you come to Toulouse next year so I can meet you again, Ian, and finally meet you, JR? Roman asked that.
The same Roman. This is from Roman FV.
Ah, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Really on it.
I would love that. Hello from Alaska, Jenna. Hi, Jenna. I did a movie in Fairbanks years ago. Loved that experience. That was amazing. Cold. It was so cold.
Mm-hmm. Cold doesn't bother me.
I stood on top of a van when we were at the highest point in Fairbanks, on the top of that mountain, you know, that observatory up there. And we were shooting a scene up there. It was the highest point. I think it was -52 or something.
Yeah, I remember you telling me.
Stood on top of the van.
You lost your glove.
Took a piss, yeah, and my pee froze before it hit the ground. It was amazing. Really, really fascinating. How was the cold filming Wind River, Ian?
It wasn't that cold, actually. It was just in between seasons that there was still snow on the ground, but for me, the temperature wasn't. It was very comfortable. Plus, you got to wear boots and hats. And
Alicia wants to know what's going on with Little Women.
Little Women is in post-production, I assume, and they're going to look for a market for it as soon as possible. Hopefully, soon, maybe by the end of the year, depending. It is a Christmas, it ends with a Christmas time period and a theme, and so that would be nice to have it out over the holidays, maybe right before Thanksgiving, I hope. I can't wait to see it. I hope I don't suck. Do you ever work and then finish and then think about, like, later, like, a couple weeks later, think about your scenes and God be like, what if I sucked? Do you think that? You don't.
I do. I absolutely do.
Okay.
I do
all
that
the time. And then I go, it'll wake me up and I'll think, holy shit, what if everyone knows but me?
Of course.
And then I'm like,
that I do. I think
I'll
called
keep
you
trying.
At times when I'm like,
okay. So I always
spinning
that
in a fucking shame spiral of like, did I just fuck that up? When are you coming to Italy, maybe Venice?
Should we go visit Daniel?
Oh, maybe we should.
Maybe spend Thanksgiving American style in.
I want to go to Thailand for the month of November.
A whole month?
Want to come, Emmanuel as well. Can you guys come to Philadelphia so that I can finally meet you both, Chloe?
Oh, okay.
We'll meet you halfway.
Want to book a flight?
How far away is Philadelphia? I've never been to Philadelphia.
It's in Pennsylvania.
Devin wants to know, JR, are you going to try to do Life Ride next year? Devin, I mean.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Life Ride is life changing.
And I would have done it this year. And it was just that when the movie came and a couple of other actors fell out of the movie, so then it came to me and I just, there was no way that I, you know, I needed that week to sort of prep and to get ready for that guy, because it was meaningful, and so I had to pull out a Life Ride. So next year, definitely. Hell yeah!
Definitely.
Do you guys have a PO, Molly wants to know, do you guys have a PO box so I can send you both stuff, because I can't meet you? And lots of crying.
You know, guys, we do. Volleyball. You can, you know, always send it to just representation, you know, agents, managers. But even then, save your money, donate it to something, okay. And you know, if you want
to, if you desperately want to get something to us, then yes,
you definitely can.
Our reps have their addresses are posted on IMDb Pro or IMDb.
Yeah,
it's easy to find out. That.
But don't spend any money on us.
No.
Really, you know, donate to AMFAR, to Love Is Louder, to CFL.
Cystic Fibrosis, exactly. So. Love Is Louder. Those are three great ones. AMFAR, yeah. Love Is Louder, Cystic Fibrosis, brilliant.
And the 18 for 18 Project, which is a Somali Moms One Heart Foundation for sex trafficking.
God, fucking hell. Can you say hi to Chloe and Megan Wilson?
What's up, Chloe and Megan?
Just Wilson. That's say my name. Rebecca Moira.
Moira.
Do you say hi, Lucia, please, guys?
Lucha.
Do you say hi, Lucha, please, guys?
Ciao, Lucha.
Do you watch Arden's YouTube channel? I do not.
I haven't seen it, but if you know, I've seen it. She's a singer.
Would, what profession? Oh, if you were not an actor, what profession would you be? Architect.
I might be a pilot. I love aircraft and aviation.
You do love aircraft and aviation.
Mm-hmm. I love flying. Love planes.
Aja wants to know, would you rather play a bad guy or a positive one? Hello from Bosnia.
Bad guy. So much more interesting. I'm just a shitty good guy.
That didn't sound right. Why can't you stop it? Molly Ball, will you come to London soon so I can find you?
I think we're going to do something in London next year. I'll fill you in more.
Am I going to be invited to that?
Of course.
I hope so. Never anyone that one from you. That's not true. That is a bold-faced lie.
Is that expression bold face or bald face?
Bald. I think it's bold. Not bald.
What is a bold face?
Bold. You're being bold. You're being so bold, you're making a face, a lie to my face. A bold face lie.
I'm not sure.
Is that what it is?
Right.
It's not a bold face.
I think
face
about
lie. Bald face would be like, you'd be bold. 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 Bald face lie. Bald face lie? Bold face lie.
I don't know.
Bold face lie. I think you're being so bold.
Bold.
You do sometimes bold. You do sometimes bold.
I have to leave now. Oh, God.
I sent a kiss to Brazil. We love you, Karina Mendes. God, we couldn't have timed that better. I love Brazil. Okay, maybe that's it.
Guys, we'll see you in a few weeks. Maybe a few weeks.
Why? Oh, like, so when can we do this again?
I don't know. I have to work. I don't know when we'll be in town on a Saturday or a Sunday in the month of September. Maybe.
You don't know when you're going to be in town?
On a Saturday. I don't think I'm in town any Saturday for the month of September.
Are you kidding?
No.
Do I need to come to Utah?
You want to come to Park City? It's super easy and fun.
No, I'm busy.
So easy. It's an hour flight. I'll buy you a ticket.
Oh. How's the Wi-Fi up there?
How's the Wi-Fi? I don't have a wife.
I know that.
Everything's good.
Okay. Guys, we love you all.
Thank you for tuning in.
We appreciate each and every damn one of you.
That's true.
And we will do this.
Until you stop watching.
Well,
and then we'll just do it still, probably.
Just
when the aliens come and they will see the unwatched episode of the two men, the greatest of all time.
God, amazing. We love you guys. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see y'all soon.
Bye.